Well, students, in the last class, in the last lecture, I discussed the relation m is equal to 2d, that is an outcome of Avogadro's hypothesis. Similarly, we also attain a relation, molar volume of any gas, that is 22.4 liter. In both the cases, we derive those conditions, we prove m is equal to 2d and molar volume is equal to 22.4 liter. Now, and we also carried out some problems, some tricky problems, some orientational problems related to those topics. And today we'll start the next application of Avogadro's hypothesis. So write down the next idea suggests if we consider any substance, 1 gram mole of any substance, it may exist in solid, liquid, or gaseous state. It contains a fixed number of molecules in it. So the previous two statements, vapor density is equal to half of molecular mass or molar volume is equal to 22.4 liter, that two statements are true only for gases. But this statement, now it is applicable to every state of matter, whether it is liquid or solid or gas, this statement will be applicable. So I am writing this statement first. Number three, application three. Application 3. One gram mole of any substance, that may exist in solid or liquid or gases. Or gases contains a fixed number of molecules, number of molecules in it, Okay, this is called Avogadro's number. Avogadro's number. Okay, represented by, this number is represented by, N suffix A, capital N suffix A, or maybe it can also be represented by n suffix 0. So you just take one of the representation, either you take, you represent n suffix a or by n suffix 0. So you just take either of the form, whether you can represent it by na. So when you represent it by n suffix a, in the total copies, in the total answer script, you just represent Avogadro number always by n suffix a. If you represent it by n suffix 0, no problem, you should represent it throughout n suffix 0. The value of Avogadro's number, Avogadro's number was determined by R A Millikan in the year 1913 by his famous oil drop experiment. Okay, the value the value is found to be, is found to be, found to be 6.022 into 10 raised to the power 23. Now, Avogadro's number, it will be this. This will be the value of Avogadro's number. So, listen, students, the Avogadro's hypothesis, in the earlier class I discussed when this concept of Avogadro's hypothesis developed. It was developed in the year 1813. So in the 1813, in the year 1813, the concept given by Avogadro in Italy, he was an Italian scientist. So that the concept given by Avogadro, that is 1 gram mole substance contains a fixed number of molecules, and what will be that number, the scientist required almost 100 years to determine this value. So see, the Avogadro's number was determined in the year, was established in the year, the concept of Avogadro's number that was established in the year 1813 by Amedeo Avogadro, but that value was determined in the year 1913, and that was done by R.A. Millikan, who was an American scientist. So definitely the concept of science, the progress of science, it is beyond the limit. It is beyond the periphery of the country or something others. So the concept which was given in the year 1813, that value was determined in the year in some different country by some different scientists. And this is the, this will call the progress of science, how it progresses. Maybe a value, a concept that requires maybe 100 years or 200 years to develop. Definitely, but it will be developed after certain stages. Okay. Now, next we have to go through how we can establish this concept, how we can prove this, similar to previous two concept, how we can prove this idea. Okay. So, definitely think, by using Avogadro's hypothesis, what can I do? From Avogadro's hypothesis, I can establish only 1 gram mole of any substance that will contain a fixed number of molecules. But by using Avogadro's hypothesis, I cannot determine this value exactly, because that was not performed by, that cannot be carried out by Avogadro itself. Then how can I do that? Okay, so when I carry out the calculations, so our target will be to find out the 1 gram mole of any substance, it will contain a fixed number of molecules in it. Okay, so let us try to prove that concept. So, proof. Proof. So, definitely, I am repeating again, by using this Avogadro's hypothesis, we will only try to prove that 1 gram mole of any substance contains a fixed number of molecules in it. It cannot be established that Avogadro number will be 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. That value cannot be determined from this proof, because that concept was an experimental determination that was done by R.A. Millikan by his charge by mass ratio calculation, or maybe that is called the oil drop experiment. So that was an experimental technique. You will learn it in higher classes. Okay. So proof. So before doing that proof, now I would like to say what is meant by 1 gram mole. So 1 gram mole means if you take carbon dioxide, if you take 44 gram of carbon dioxide. So 44 gram of carbon dioxide is said to be 1 mole. Similarly, if we take sulfur dioxide, then molar mass of sulfur dioxide, it is 64. That 64 gram of sulfur dioxide, it is called 1 gram mole. So 1 gram mole means actually the molecular mass expressed in gram. The amount of substance, that is its molecular weight expressed in gram, that is called in simple words 1 gram mole. Okay, so let us take, let कैपिटल एम, बी द मोलर मास, बी द मोलर मास, मोलर मास, मोलर मास ऑफ एनी सब्सटेंस, ऑफ एनी सब्सटेंस, इट इज द मोलर मास ऑफ एनी सब्सटेंस, देयरफॉर ग्राम मोलर मास और ग्राम मॉलिक्यूलर मास, ग्राम मोलर मास, ग्राम मोलर मास मीन्स मोलर मास एक्सप्रेस्ड इन ग्राम, दैट इज एम ग्राम. नाउ व्हाट इज आवर टारगेट? आवर टारगेट इज टू फाइंड आउट that m gram of the substance that will contain a fixed number of molecules. I have to prove one m gram of the substance, it will contain a fixed number of molecules. That is my target. Okay, so we have this idea, the molar mass or molecular weight. What is this basic definition? I will start from the very, very basic definition of molecular mass. So molecular mass of any substance, it represents a molecule of any substance, it is how much times heavier than one atom of hydrogen. A mass of a molecule of any substance, it is how much times heavier than one atom of hydrogen. So I am starting from the very basic definition. So by definition we can write m is equal to mass of one molecule of any substance by mass of one atom of hydrogen, one atom of hydrogen. So this is the very basic definition of molar mass or molecular mass. Now think, if we study this definition, so what is the variable quantity here? The mass of one molecule of a substance. So if the substance differs, so its mass will differ. If we take CO2, it will have a particular mass. If we take SO2, it will have a particular mass. If we take O2, it will have a particular mass. But this quantity, mass of one atom of hydrogen, that is a fixed quantity. So I can write m is equal to mass of one molecule of any substance by, so since it is a constant, I can write, let this value is x gram, say. I am considering that mass of one atom of hydrogen, it is x gram. Okay, so what can I write from the next statement? Mass of one molecule of any substance that will be equal to m into x gram, just by doing a cross multiplication. Okay, so next, what can I do? The next statement, what can I do? So what can I write from this statement? So just I am trying to revert this statement. Okay, so mass of one molecule of any substance that will have the mass mx gram. So I can write mx gram of any substance that will contain one molecule. I am just reverting this statement. So I can write from here mx gram of any substance, mx gram of any substance contain one molecule. Okay, so I'm just reverting this statement, mx gram contains one molecule. So our target to find out m gram contains how many molecules. If I can show that number is fixed quantity, then it can prove that 1 gram mole of any substance that will contain a fixed number of molecules, that is equals to 1 by x molecule. So since x is equal to constant, say x is a mass of hydrogen atom, that is a fixed quantity. So if x is a constant, therefore 1 by x is also constant. So what I am getting? I am getting m gram contains 1 by x molecule. Since x is constant, so 1 by x is also constant. So m gram means 1 gram mole. So 1 gram mole of any substance, it will contain a fixed number of molecules. Hence, I can write 1 gram mole means m gram contains a fixed number of molecules, okay. So this is the statement which we have to prove. Okay, now after that I can just extend this concept. Just I am slightly, if a question is asked, how you can prove 1 gram mole of any substance, it will contain a fixed number of molecules in it. So you have to do up to this. It is not mg, it is m gram. Okay. Now, experimentally, I can extend this concept a little bit. So experimentally, x is found to be from different experiment, we can find out the value of x. It is possible to find out the mass of one hydrogen atom. It is found to be 1.66 × −24 grams. Okay, so the value of x experimentally or by any means we find this value of x, it is 1.66 × 10⁻²⁴ grams. Okay, so I can write, therefore 1 gram mole contains 1 gram mole of any substance contains, I find it in the earlier case, it contains 1 by x molecules. So 1 by x molecules, just follow up carefully. 1 gram mole of any substance contains 1 by x molecules. I have got the value of x, so I can put the value x 1 by 1.66 × −24 molecules. If you reciprocal this number, if you find out this number in calculator or something others, any other gadgets, so you will get the value 6.022 × 10⁻²23 molecules. Okay, 6.022 × 10⁻²23 molecules. Okay, so if the question is asked, you can extend this concept up to this. Okay, now one term we have reached till now, I am not wipe out this statement why. Now you write this statement again. So this statement provide mass of one molecule of any substance, it is mx gram. So just see here, the variable quantity, it is m. The value of m will vary, but the x will always remain constant. That x is equal to, we have 1.66 × 10⁻²⁴ gram. Now, since this value of x, it is always remaining constant, so this is taken as a unit. Since a molecule is very, very lighter beyond our imagination, a molecule of any substance, it is very, very lighter. So to represent any quantity by its suitable unit, we introduce a term which is called AMU for determining the mass of atomic system. It is, we can write it is AMU, 1 AMU. So AMU, AMU means atomic mass unit. In the recent days, we just write it, this value, only U. Okay, or we can also write this value as MDA, Dalton. All these will represent the same thing, one atomic mass unit, one AMU, that is equal to, that will mean, that will have the full form, atomic mass unit. That will have the atomic mass unit. So 1 AMU, it will be equal to 1.66 10 raised to minus 24 grams. Okay, 1 AMU is equal to this. Or we can, I can also write 1 AMU, it can also be represented by 1 U. U means unified mass. In recent days, we just write U. Not MU, I just write U. Okay, or that may also be written as 1 Dalton. The same thing, 1 Dalton, or that is equals to 1.66 into 10 raised to minus 24 grams. Okay. So these things you have to memorize, these things you have to keep it in your mind. Okay, so listen, if from 8th standard you know, if it is asked, what will be the mass of Avogadro number of CO2? If somebody ask you, what is the mass of Avogadro number of CO2, immediately you say it is 44 gram, because you can correlate it, you can make a correlation that Avogadro number, it reflects the mass of 1 gram mole of substance, and 1 gram mole means molar mass expressed in gram. Okay, now if somebody asks now, from this stage, if somebody asks you, what will be the mass of one molecule of CO2? What will be the mass of one molecule of CO2? So immediately you will say this value will be 44 AMU. Mass of molecule of any substance, it is MU or MAMU or M Dalton. So immediately you find out its molar mass. Then only say that AMU or U, so it will represent mass of one molecule. So if somebody asks what will be the mass of sulfur dioxide, one molecule of sulfur dioxide, immediately you can say it will be 64 U or 64 AMU. If somebody asks what will be the mass in gram, then you convert this AMU into gram. So it will be 64 into 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 grams. Okay, now after completing this, let us try to do some problems related to this topic. I think it is clear. Now, when I will write some problems here first, so just like that a previous class, I'm telling again that you just pause the video. When I am writing the problem, you just pause your video, you just try that problem by yourself, and then check whether you have done right or wrong. Okay, so I am writing the first problem. Today, the first problem. Basically, the problems are asked related to molecules, atoms or something others. So I can write the first problem. Calculate the number of atoms, number of atoms present in 0.32 grams of sulfur dioxide. Suppose this problem is asked, calculate the number of atoms present in 0.32 gram of sulfur dioxide. Now think first, what you will do, what will be your approach? So what I have, first you have to find out the molar mass of SO2, molecular weight of SO2. So it is very common to you, it is 64 grams. Then find out 0.32 grams means how much moles or how much gram moles. Then you think one molecule of SO2 contains how many atoms. So by any means, if you can find out the number of molecules in 0.32 gram, the number of molecules in 0.32 gram, then you know one at molecule of SO2, it is made up of one sulfur atom, two oxygen atoms, so it will have three atoms total. So if you can find out the number of molecules in 0.32 gram, then that value will be multiplied by 3, that will represent the total number of atoms present in it. So let us try to do it. Okay, so first, molar mass. What will be your approach? Molar mass of SO2. Molar mass of SO2. These things you have to memorize. Sulfur has atomic mass 32. Oxygen has atomic mass 16. That is 64. Those students who don't have this value in their memorization, so immediately they have to memorize this value. The atomic mass you have to memorize, at least for 20 atomic number you have to memorize this value. As for example, hydrogen 1, maybe carbon 12, nitrogen 14, oxygen 16, sodium 23, magnesium 24, aluminium 27, silicon 28, phosphorus 31, sulfur 32, chlorine 35.5, potassium 39, calcium 20, calcium 40. At least you have to memorize the values up to this stage. Okay. So molar mass of SO2, it is 64. So I can write here. So 64 grams of SO2, that is equivalent to, so I can write 64 gram means it will represent 1 gram mole, or simple 1 mole SO2. So 0.32 gram of SO2, that will represent 0.32 by 64 gram moles. So it leads to, I can write, this leads to definitely 32 by 64 into 100. So it is 0.5, that means 0.005 gram mole SO2. So I have determined first, this contains, this 0.32 gram contains how much moles. Always try to express this value in terms of moles. Now in the first case I determine it by just unitary method, but in the second cases, in the next problems, I will not carry out these orientations. It is very simple. If you have the mass in gram, just divide it by its molar mass. If you have mass in gram, just divide it by its molar mass, you will get the number of moles. So in the next problems, I will not show these steps. I'll just write 6.32 gram of SO2, that means it will be 32.32 by 64. So weight given by molar mass of that substance, that will represent the gram moles. Okay, now next I will try to find out this gram mole, it contains how much molecules of SO2. So in the next stage I can write 1 gram mole SO2. Already Avogadro's application this suggests 1 gram mole of any substance, it contains Avogadro's number of molecules. Molecules of SO2. Contains Avogadro's number of molecules of SO2. So, 0.05 gram mole SO2 it contains. So, it will be 6.022 into 10 raised to 23.005 molecules of SO2. Okay, so always I can adjust this value. I can adjust this value with respect to 10 to the power terms. So it becomes 022 into 5 into 10 raised to the power, it will be 20 molecules. Now, it will be the second phase of the problem. Just think this problem in different stages. And when you learn it properly, so you can do this in simple one step or two step problems. For the very beginning learners, for the beginners, definitely I am trying to convert these steps each. Okay, so I am the mass given, I am converting into moles. Then moles from I will move to molecules, then molecules I will move to atoms. Okay, so next I can write one molecule SO2 that refers to how many atoms? One sulfur, two oxygen, it refers to three atoms. So simple, I have now how many number of molecules? I have 6.022 into 5 into 10 raised to 20 molecules. So the answer will be definitely it is 6.022 into 5 into 3 into 10 raised to 10 to the power 20. Okay, 20 atoms. 10 raised to 20 atoms. So you can carry out this calculation. I am doing very fast. So it will be 15. So 15 to the 30. 15 to the 30, 32. So it will be. And 15, 6 the 90. 15, 6 the 90. Okay. 15, 6 the 90. So into 10 raised to 20 atoms. Now, always here one thing you have to memorize, one thing you have to be familiar with the fact that you think Avogadro's number. I am writing Avogadro's number 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. So you can say, you can ask me, sir, why I am writing this value always 6.022 into 10 to the power 23? Why? What is the problem of writing this value 60.22 into 10 to the power 22? Why not I am writing this value 0.6022 into 10 to the power 24? These are also right. Then why you are telling always it will be 6.022 into 10 to the power 23? Why I am not telling 60.22 into 10 to the power 22? So actually, if you you can say all those values are right, but the scientific community, the IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, the IUPAC decided you can describe the value in your own words. But when you have to report a particular value, so you should always represent this value with respect to one decimal place. That means always I am writing this value as something, digit will be there, and then give the decimal, then you represent all those values. Okay. So here also you have got this result 90.320 into 10 to the power 20. So always try to represent it with respect to one decimal place. So I can write it. So just make multiplication by 10, both denominator and numerator. So I can write it 90.32 into 10 raised to the power 21. 10 raised to the power 21. I am multiplying both numerator and denominator by 10. So the numerator, it adjusted to 10 to the power 20, it will be 21. The denominator, it is adjusted to 90.23. So divided by 10, it will get the value 90.023 into 032 into 10 to the power 21. So this will be the basic level calculation. Maybe I think that is no mistake. I expect, I hope that is no mistake. But this will be the our conceptual delivery. Always we try to solve this problem by these concepts. Now, you have to be acquainted with these facts. Always, if it is gram, if the mass of the substance is given in gram, try to convert it into mole. Just dividing it by its molar mass. If the number of moles you got, you can find out the number of molecules by multiplying that moles is 0.02005 in this case. Multiply it by Avogadro number, you will get the number of molecules. Then number of molecules, from number of molecules, you can move to number of atoms by multiplying, and a molecule contains how many number of atoms. This is a very basic approach. You have to follow up this approach, and when you become familiar, when you have that confidence, then always try to convert it in single steps. You just write 0.32 gram, it will represent 0.32 by 64 moles. When you have got that number of moles, you just multiply it by Avogadro number, you will get the number of molecules. You just, when you got this idea, then you multiply it by number of atoms per molecule, will get the total number of atoms present in it. Okay, I think it is clear to you. Now, move to second problem. Today, we'll discuss so many problems related to this chapter. Definitely, this chapter is important not for your only class 9th level, 9th standard. This chapter is also important in your next stages. Definitely, in class 10th standard, you have these concepts again. The questions are asked from these ideas. And even when you move to class 11th standard, this will also have this concept of moles. Okay, so next problem 2. I will just grade up those problems. The difficulty level, I will just increase the difficulty level of the problems. Okay, so next I am writing calculate number of electrons present in 0.62 grams of NO3 minus ion. Just copy this problem, pause the video, just try yourself and then check whether with my result. So it is given 0.62 gram, so our concept will remain the same. Number of electrons, the value it is asked, we have to find out the number of electrons present in 0.62 gram of NO3 minus. So our basic idea. Now I will just skip those steps. So the first, calculate molar mass of NO3 minus, it will be nitrogen 14, oxygen 16 into 3, it leads to 62. Okay, so I will write 0.62 gram NO3 minus. Now I will skip the steps. I will not write all the steps. Now 0.62 gram. In the previous problem, I discussed that the mass given, we just divide it by molar mass. So it will be 0.62 by 62 moles NO3 minus. So definitely it leads to 0.01 moles. NO3 minus. Now then you have to convert how many molecules of NO3 minus present. You have to find out how many molecules of NO3 minus present. So I can write again in the next step how many molecules, 0.01 into 6.022 into 10 raised to the 23 molecules per number of NO3 minus ions. It is not a molecule, so we should not write molecule. Number of NO3 minus ions. So just follow up. I am just skipping these steps. Now 0.01 mole. 0.01 mole means how many molecules? So 1 mole NO3 minus means Avogadro number. So 0.01 means that will represent definitely 6.022 into 10 raised to the power 21 number NO3 minus. So I just find out this 0.62 gram contains how many NO3 minus ions. I just find out this result first. Now next our target, it is asked how many electrons are present. So definitely first we have to find out how many electrons are present in one NO3 minus ion. So I am writing, so one NO3 minus ion contains 1 NO3 minus ion contains so how many electrons? Nitrogen, say nitrogen, it will have atomic number. Now nitrogen has atomic number 7, so it has 7 protons, definitely it will have 7 electrons. So nitrogen contributing 7 electrons. So oxygen has atomic number, it is 8. So 8 protons, that means 8 electrons. So oxygen contributing, it is 8 electrons each. So 3 oxygen atoms, it will be 8 into 3. And definitely one negative charge is there. One additional electron is there. So add 1 electron. Okay, so I will get this value. 24 plus 8 32 electrons. If I am not making any mistake, it will be 32 electrons. Nitrogen 7 8 and followed by 24 8 3 is 24 31 32 electrons. So definitely 6.022 10 to the power 21 NO3 minus it contains. So one NO3 minus contains 32 electrons. So it will be 32 into 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 electrons. This will be the answer. Definitely you have to find out the result, the conclusive result. You can 32, it is 64, 70, and it will be 12 92 into 10 to the power 23 electrons. So I have to adjust this result, just multiplying both numerator and denominator by 100. So you will get the value 1.92704 into 10 raised to the power 25 electrons. Okay, you can approximate it up to 1.92 or 1.93 10 raised to 25. Okay, so if small calculation errors are there, if you find any calculation errors, so you have to correct those things. Okay.